Well, hello everybody, it's Richard Macintyre here. Welcome back to my channel, one and all. And this afternoon I'm going to do a couple of things. I'm going to play a request, and I've just left the piece of paper over here. Hang on a second. Best my plans of mice and men. Right, I'd like to play a request for Paul Wilson and Richard White, who would like to hear a David Whitfield singing of a... some of his famous songs. This album you're looking at here, this EP, was the one that I played on the Melody, the French machine, and back in a previous video, I think it was, yes. And no, it wasn't actually. No, take you back. It was the Philips one. I think it was the 134. So I've done so much recently, I forget where I've got to. So yes. So this afternoon, I thought I'd play something a little different, not on an EP, though I will play the rest of this record at some stage in the proceedings. But I'm going to play "Love, Tears and Kisses" by David on 78. Partly because I'm going to be using the 78, both HMV 103 table grand and also the Columbia Glofronia 118 table grand to do a comparison. That's the second part of this video. So I'm going to play this first bit, which is "Love, Tears and Kisses", okay, and then I'm going to move on after that to use the same record. So it's going to be "I Double Dare You", sung by El Boley with Lou Stone on his band. And this record I bought back in 2009, so that's quite a while ago now, looking at the notes that I kept on myself. So there are two things I'm going to do, because I had a request to do a comparison between the two machines. Now, what you have to remember is that one of them hasn't been refurbished yet, so that's the HMV 103, though it sounds pretty good. But the other machine, the Glofronia, the Columbia Glofronia 118, was the one that I saved from a skip, and I've slowly managed to find parts for it, a genuine Decca part, not Decca, but genuine Columbia parts for it, so on that note. And also I'd like to thank viewers for wishing me well with my cold. It is, you can hear it, slightly better this afternoon. Occasionally I get the occasional sort of coughing fit, which really annoys me, but I'm not the best person when it comes to being ill, I tell you. Anyway, without further ado, let's play David Whitfield, and I'm going to play that on the Columbia 118. So here we go, "Love, Tears and Kisses" by David Whitfield. Enjoy.
Thank you. David Whitfield and Love, Tears and Kisses. So this machine doesn't have a brake, so auto brake, so I'm going to... There we go, fine. And I hope that was enjoyed by both my viewers and everybody else. So, see you on the next one. So moving on, we're now going to do the comparison between this gramophone, which is the Columbia Gramophone, using a number 4 soundbox, HMV. I don't have a Columbia soundbox to compare that, but also we're going to compare that against the HMV 103 machine, which is over here. Okay, so let's, without further ado, let's play this. And it's I Double Dare You by Al Bowie. That's Al Bowie and I Double Dare You. So I'm now going to move you to the HMV 103. So hold fire. So same record, except on the HMV 103 with a number 5A soundbox. Thank you.
I double dare you to sit over here. I double dare you to lend me your ear. Take off your high hat and let's get friendly. Don't be a scarecat, say what do you care? Can't you take a dare? I double dare you to kiss me and then. I double dare you to kiss me again. And if that look in your eyes means what I'm thinking of, I double dare you to fall in love with me. I double dare you.
Burley doing the same thing again, and on the HMV 103. I think actually this machine sounds slightly more in tune in terms of speed, but I'll let you be the judge of that. The Columbia over there has always been on point when it comes to speed, but sometimes the temperature and atmosphere does affect gramophones. And also, of course, this machine you're looking at now hasn't been serviced, and I have got the speed selector slightly slow because I did feel it was slightly fast when I actually purchased it a few months ago, and I've had it in the workshop for about 2 years. But I hope that was an interesting comparison. The microphone, as you can see on this stand, has been in the same place for both machines, so they're double elliptical horn machines, so that's a fair comparison. The difference will be the sound box. This one you're looking at now has got an aluminium diaphragm, double supported, where the Columbia has a micro diaphragm, does produce a slight different sound. This one, the number four box, is very popular. I use this on a lot of my machines, but I'll let you be the judge of that, and look forward to your comments. Thanks very much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and press the little reminder bell. And see you on the next one. Take care.